This section is all about Amazon DynamoDB, the NoSQL serverless database from AWS. First, we'll quickly compare SQL and NoSQL terminologies and then dive into Amazon DynamoDB console to create our first DynamoDB table. You will learn how to use the DynamoDB console to create tables, add items to the table, modify or remove items from the table, export items from the table, and also how to use the query and scan operations on the DynamoDB tables. After that, we'll look at what NoSQL is and how does it compare with the traditional relational databases. Just to recap, Amazon DynamoDB is a fast, high-performance, cost-effective, serverless NoSQL database that can scale on demand to support virtually unlimited number of read-write operations with response times under single-digit milliseconds. And with DynamoDB Accelerator or DAX, you can bring down these response times further into microseconds. Before we get into hands-on exercises, let's quickly compare SQL and NoSQL terminology. In SQL, we have tables, and in DynamoDB, we have tables as well. SQL tables have rows and columns. DynamoDB tables have items and attributes. SQL tables have primary key that can have several columns, whereas DynamoDB tables have a primary key that can have minimum one and maximum two attributes. The mandatory attribute is called as a partition key, and the optional attribute is called as a sort key. Again, in SQL, we have indexes, and in DynamoDB, we have local secondary indexes. In SQL, we have views. In DynamoDB, we have global secondary indexes. Now, what are these local and global secondary indexes? Local secondary indexes are the indexes where the partition key is same as that of the primary key, while global secondary indexes are the indexes where partition key is different from that of the primary key. Now, as part of our hands-on exercise, we are going to create a DynamoDB table to store information about projects in a project management system. Let's say we are going to create a serverless application and we have three projects under it: backend development, web application development, and mobile app development. So we can add information about these three projects in our projects table. This table will have a primary key composed of a partition key and a sort key. Partition key will be a project ID and sort key would be a WBS ID. WBS is a work breakdown structure, and you can think of this as an activity within a project. So for example, backend development project will have activities or WBS elements like DynamoDB setup, microservices development, API development, quality testing, and so on. Similarly, web application development will have WBS elements like web app development, documentation, QA, testing, go live, post go live support, and so on. Each of these activities will have a Spark or a single point of contact, as well as a start and end date. So in the next lesson, we'll create this table using the AWS DynamoDB console.